So, you see this thing right above my face right now?
It wasn't even intentional.
Oh, God. Alright, as you can see, Mike, with his ingenuity, created something really cool to try to train the bass. Tell us about what you got here.
Man, I just got this long fly rod, and I hooked a clothespin on the end, and we're gonna get the little shiner on the tail with the clothespin and droop it over the pond.
I don't know if this is gonna work, but we're gonna find out.
Alright, so I'm just gonna hook the shiner right here on the tail with the clothespin. That way when the bass grabs a hold of it, he can just pull it right out of the clothes hanger.
So right now, Mike is looking for the bass.
I gotta go on that side because I don't want the shadow to scare me.
Yeah. Let's see if that'll work. Try dropping it again, like pulling out the water and dropping it again. Okay, this is a lot tougher than we thought. The clothesline, though I thought it was really a good idea, it didn't work. The bass saw the clothesline, like, you know, that don't even look right. So we're gonna try just like monofilament. We're gonna just try to put that around them, just wrap it around the body, see if we can get them close. We want them to feed in front of the camera. That's the main thing. So we just gotta get them to get there.
Ah, I caught a bass.
Wow, he went and got it while it was still in the water. Okay, now that we played around with the bass for a little bit, it's time to build a stock tank for your shiners. It's a temporary stock tank. It's not meant to be permanent. It's just something to just hold your shiners until your next trip or until you feed it to your pet bass.
So there is some cheap basic components that you're gonna need in order to make this. First thing that you're gonna need is a small aerator. Now these are sold for boats. This is actually designed to go inside of a boat, but if you use it for this, it works just fine, and you just need a 12 volt power supply. The next thing that you're gonna need is some hose. And the hose is gonna go from your aerator itself, and then it's gonna go to your sprayer. The sprayer is made up of four components. Okay, it's one single piece of 3/4 inch pipe, and you drill holes down it. On the end, you want to put a 3/4 inch PVC cap. On the other end, you want to put a 3/4 inch male adapter. And then on the last part, you want to put this adapter. I'm not sure what it's called, but you can buy this at the hardware store. The 3/4 inch goes into there, and then your flex hose can attach to that. You're gonna go from this, and you're just gonna poke this in here nice and tight. Like that. And then you're gonna connect the other end to your bilge pump, aerator, whatever you wanna call it. Like that. Booyah. I'm just gonna connect this little butt connector and hook the wires up on the aerator.
That's the last one, right?
Yep. There we are, connected. Now, don't get the idea that I'm running 120 volt electricity with this. This is just a piece of extension cord that I had. I'm just using the wire from it. So don't do this. Don't plug this into a wall and connect it to an extension cord. You'll burn your pump up.
just savagery.
We don't need the green wire.
We don't need it.
Cause this ain't a green project or anything. Booyah. Okay.
Got him.
Now what we got here is a 12 volt DC power supply. Actually it's 13.8 volts, but that's what you need. And then it's got a power switch to turn it off and on. We're gonna connect these real quick. And we are all connected. We got power. I got the power. Oh, I don't have the power yet. And we're just gonna finish up. We put heat shrink tape underneath this to keep it, to make it water resistant on the wires so they don't get corroded. And we are ready for submersion.
All right, now we got it in there. We're working on it. All we gotta do is clamp it.
Okay, what we're gonna do next is we're just gonna drill a hole right here in the tip and right here, and then we're just gonna wire tie this to the side of the barrel so it can spray down.
As you can see, he measured it completely. Completely been measured.
Don't die on me now.
Better drill. Never even had a chance. Got the wire ties.
Now ain't that some ingenuity right there? Who would have ever thunk of it? You know, some things in life aren't too awful complicated. Some people try to make things so complicated to do, and it's so easy. All you need, some duct tape, some wire ties. You can build just about anything.
Yep. There it is. That is not a permanent stock tank. It's a temporary stock tank. It's quick, cheap to make. How much did it cost you to make?
It was $15.99 for the pump, and it was another $10 or so for the hose and the fitting.
He already had the barrel. You could use a trash can. Same concept, anything that could hold water, a large amount of water, you could just do it. I mean, and it'll be fine.
Let me tell you something about this. It's better than a bubbler, okay? Bubbles don't actually introduce oxygen. It takes water flow to introduce oxygen into the water.
And that's good information to know. Again, it's temporary, it's not permanent. It's just to get you, keep your fish alive to your next fishing trip or until you feed it to your pet bass. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button.
Hit that subscribe button.
Follow us on all social media.
And never forget to challenge the outdoors.